Finally going to be going live here. It's Virtus Pro and Dignitas. So welcome, ladies and gentlemen. Here it's the grand finals of Epicenter Moscow. And we're ready. First map coming up. Out of three. Magisk already holding down towards the ramp room. And he's been lethal with this USP here before. Going to miss a couple of clicks and falls back down, which I absolutely love seeing. Let's see if they can actually rotate in well enough here. Grenade goes up, but Cajun picking up two kills anyway, shutting them down. And Magisk finally, or Cajun finally going to be out of the round there. But still a good situation here for Dignitas.
Oh, the parting shot from Bialy, though, that could change everything. Brings it back into a 3-on-3. And now Taz chimes in. He takes that Rubino. Taz comes out of nowhere on Heaven. And it's going to be Config in a 1v3 now. And he's been spotted by Taz as well. Bit of a burst shot, Taz styling. And well, Config, what are you going to do? You've got 40 HP. And the bomb has been planted already.
I mean, there's pretty much nothing that can be done here. He hasn't got the fuse kit either. Great move from Taz that obviously caught Dignitas entirely off guard from a 4v3 into a one round. They didn't lose anybody. Taz with a quad kill. Virtus Pro winning the T-side pistol.
What a huge round. I think the death of MSL, rather, in Hutt at the hands of Bialy is a huge changing factor there. That focus, it draws the focus from Dignitas all back to the upper site all of a sudden, and then Taz is like, eh, because they might be thinking they're going down ramp at that point, but Taz on the money with the flank up Heaven. No idea how he got up there alive, unnoticed, and then he just breaks open the defense entirely. Quad kill for Taz in that round, in that pistol, showing that he's still got it, that he can still hang with the youngsters, Magic Boy and Cajun, I mean, and Config come to mind.
Config out here, a deagle in hand, already doing a little bit of damage with the teammate helping out, but they can't quite get the kill. Rubino just gonna get the one. Cajun has a scout in play, but don't think he's in a position to do much about it right now. And MSL spots them coming by, but he can't really do enough damage. And Taz following up right behind him, coming through the ladder, and it's gonna be Magisk and Cajun left, but shouldn't be much of a problem here for Virtus Pro to pick it up.
Now Cajun now 1v3, he's got a scout. Bialy and Snacks are both very low, but these incendiaries, this nade advantage that VP have, they don't care. They're just gonna throw him out because it's gonna guarantee the round. Cajun has so little time to work with now. And again, no kit for him. And he, well, yeah, that's just unfortunate. Not even gonna check right. Snacks, perfect spot to deal with it. This pace that VP are setting here right off the bat, they want to make sure that Dignitas are rattled at the start. They know that Dignitas are coming off of a short break out of a very difficult semifinals. They do not want Dignitas to get comfortable. This is all about bullying, basically, from VP. They just want to bully Dignitas early on in this map.
Yeah, they're doing a good job so far, losing a couple of players, but they know that Dignitas are not going to have armor and everything in this upcoming rounds. They can save the MAC-10s. They can just keep going here. I'm expecting that Taz and Pasha are going to be the two main entry fraggers for this particular round, and then just see where it goes. Taz already with the damage, actually almost getting surrounded in Hutt here, but he's doing a fine job staying alive. Goes back for more. Could have probably reloaded that MAC-10, so maybe a little bit greedy.
Decides to take the fight, no fear, only dreams. Two kills with the MAC-10 as well, so he's already paid that bad boy off. And well, now this is just VP needed to sit and rest. No need to rush. They've actually got the bomb towards lower site already. We're on Bialy now, who's alone out in the yard. He's the only one who's vulnerable right now for VP, although he gets a nice shot onto Config there. Had Dignitas picked up on the fact that he was alone, they might have been able to kill him off and pick up an AK to save.
You can kind of tell that that's what they want to, but they're not proving all that easy. Magisk USP, 10 health left. Obviously, not a lot that could be done with this, but gonna give himself a bit of a chance here. Doesn't get the headshot, so that will be the end of the round. Only Taz going down, and that's a quick 3-0 here for the Polish side. We'll see if they can continue now that finally Dignitas are gonna be able to pick up rifles. And this is the first real test, and it's a very important one. If you lose the pistol round on CT side here, you can kind of, you can brush that off if you win the fourth round, but if you don't, then you've dug a very deep hole for yourself. It's very hard to come back from that situation.
Yeah, if you get within range of that 05 start on a CT side, it looks grim, and man, it is going to be difficult. They don't really have anti-rush nades. They only have Magis with the HE and the incendiary. MSL had an incendiary as well, so that probably went into Hutt on upper just to slow things down, yeah. So in case VP tried to rush the upper site, at least MSL had that to delay. And Magis is still holding onto his incendiary. But VP, they're interested in going out into the yard right now. AKs across the board, a good nade count for them. And now the pressure is going to start setting in here on Dignitas to figure out what VP have got in store for him. Because this could look, this is actually possible to go for that main split. which has actually become very popular. Straight through main, straight through hut, straight to your death.
Straight into MSL, who just holds his ground there. Even gonna survive that one. Rubino coming out, MSL landing the headshot for a quick triple. Very impressive. Again, the captain and in-game leader of the Danish team here, just really stepping it up. But they also got the early kill outside, which definitely helped out a little bit.
Mm. Yeah, the challenge outside of main, that also gave them a warning, basically, a heads up.
Very well done. We'll see if they can continue. That is the first important step in the right direction. Now, the question is, they did save almost all their guns. I'm not sure if it, maybe one person died that round? I can't remember.
One person. Yeah, four people survived, so that is actually very good.
That's the other thing to look out for. Virtus Pro can lose very many rounds in the rest of this half, as long as they keep getting kills. Even if they go on a, you know, 6 or 7 round losing streak here, as long as they get 3 kills per round, that's absolutely fine.
It's just like they had the chance to just completely roll, like just roll Dignitas had they won that last buy round. But there's still a second chance. It's like a chance on top of a chance here because Dignitas, if they lose this round, then they'll be hard ecoing or like hard reset. And it should be a pretty easy round to follow up here for VP. So, I mean, there's still ways for VP to play. It's if Dignitas start chaining rounds together where life just gets really difficult for VP and they're going to have to just go into buy rounds every time. They won't have any rounds where Dignitas are going to be sitting pistols, so.
It really is a little bit different. You really got to sort of alter your mindset a little bit when you're watching Nuke, because if you just approach it like any other map, you're going to be having a worse experience, I reckon. Grenade going to be raining in. The one up on Rafters didn't quite work out, but the one on Hut certainly did. A really good Molotov being brought out there. Config going in with a headshot as well. Continuing the spray. That is some real madness, but he does pick up the double kill behind it and making life really tough here on Virtus Pro. They're down to 38 seconds.
I do like to see this from VP, though. They've got the nades. One onto Rubino. They're going to check and be thorough about it, but that was the last HE. That was the last grenade that they had to work with here for VP. Now it's all down to headshots. Pasha's going to find a kill on Magus. That was over on ramp. But with 20 seconds left, they have no time to maneuver with, and they peek together. Well played, although Taz is there to get the trade kill onto MSL. 2-on-2. 15 seconds left. Need to get that bomb plant, and it's going to be on the B site.
And Cajun gets the info as well, so can he stop them from putting down the bomb? Config's certainly not going to be able to. He's got almost no health left. Cajun charging in. That's going to be the shot now. Locked in behind is Pasha. He goes for the spray, but Cajun comes through with the double kill, and they are going to be able to save the round. A little bit scary there. Mm. That could have gone horribly wrong.
No, I do like to see that from VP, though. It's just... it felt like it was just a little bit delayed almost. You get the incendiaries down, you get the smokes down on upper site, but there wasn't really any follow-up to it. Instead, I mean, obviously the guys moving up towards main, that was where Config got his double kill. Those are the guys who were supposed to try and capitalize on it, it looked like, but
yeah,
there wasn't a huge follow-up from VP. But VP are a team on T side who have put in quite a bit of work towards making use of the windows that are opened up on the A site in the ceiling where you can start chucking nades through. We saw the Molotov go into top hut there. They've also got that the heaven smoke. And so VP have put some time, some work into preparing T-side on this map and actually having some executes to work with.
They get 3 kills in the last round, and as a result, they're going to keep up the pressure. I mean, if it was a different map, maybe they would have thought, we're not quite going to do it, you know, they can still buy it, let's just keep it cool. But here, they know that Dignitas are right at the edge, any little window here, and they can make it work. And a headshot from Neo, the scout instantly paying off, down from secret. Config is going to be coming in, gets a kill and falls back, and that's very reasonable.
Excellent work from Config, what patience. Rubino, that was probably the last thing he was expecting, to see somebody down vents. MSL goes for the peak, the pre-fire dead on! Surprise though, Bialy's holding close and they get the trade. 3-on-3 and Bialy just cleaning house on the A site. The maid service is here, Magisk is gonna get the flank back. This is chaos.
Hasn't reloaded yet, he's gonna go out right in the face of Neo, he gets one more scout headshot. Neo shutting them out of the round, very well done. And you see, because Bialy actually pushes in, he catches the player on HUD coming up the ladder, and that is just gonna kill the round there. So 4-2, and Dignitas, but they're really hard decision here.
Did they have the money to buy or not? It doesn't look like it.
You sometimes see teams, if they're feeling desperate enough, they will force on this side anyway, and that's what they've done.
Yeah.
So, and I mean, 4 rounds has already put a smile on your face if you're VP at this point in time. 5, and there's a good chance they can win the map. That's why Dignitas are under such a lot of pressure to do this. Again, any other map, you would have shrugged and said, that's all right, whatever, we'll just buy in the next round.
Yeah. That's the issue. I mean, but at the same time, you're at risk now still. You could still get into a situation where you're just your Hardy going in the next round, and VP could get up to 6 rounds on T side. Magisk is going to put that M4 to work, and that actually gives the gun to Rubino. Great team play there from Dignitas. So now they have an extra rifle to work with. But in the meantime, Virtus Pro preparing to head down towards that B site to get the wall of smokes up that leads to Secret.
We've said it before, being alone in lobby like that is very scary when you're on the terrorist side. Even having 2 people is not enough. There are 3 entrances into that lobby area, so you've got to make sure you've got everything covered. Otherwise, that can happen. 4 versus 5 here. Snax is outside with the AWP they stole from the last round, and see if they can make something off it here.
They got to be feeling like they need to find config somewhere. Where is this guy with that rifle? There's a bit of a peekaboo moment. MSL gets the glancing headshot off onto Bialy. That's going to be so frustrating with the CZ. Rubino's there with that stolen AK. Finds the kill on Pasha. They're getting whittled down here, Virtus Pro. And the gamble is paying off for Dignitas so far. They have 3 rifles, but they have all 5 players alive. And MSL should be able to catch up Bialy. No, Bialy instant headshot. That had to happen there for VP.
Bringing it back a little bit. The real problem is Neo is the only one who has any real health, so I'm not surprised he's the one initiating the fight here. Has to go and look for a kill on the A-bomb side. Not going to find anybody. Config will take him down with 8 seconds left. They're just going to save the remaining of what they have. But, I mean, yeah, what a gamble from Dignitas. But you should do that. This is the thing. You really can't afford to do anything else. Magisk, I don't think you actually can shoot through that wall with the M4. Well, you can with the AWP.
How much does it do?
Is he going to shoot for around the 37-ish mark, I think, something like that. I'm not 100% sure. The thing is, I tested this out for a different reason, because I wanted like a very specific wall bang, but it turned out to be ineffective, so I just gave up on the idea.
Aww. But
there are some other options from that particular area. We do have Scout and AWP on Neo and Snax here, keeping up the pressure. Virtus Pro really want to make sure the Danes don't have a lot to work with. And what a great opening from Bialy. Almost like he knew Config was going to do that.
Yeah, that early aggression, no possible chance at a... That's the frustrating thing with that aggressive push. Seized was doing it from Na'Vi as well, is that it's so difficult to get a trade frag. If you go down, who on your team is going to be in position to get the kill? Bialy's angle up there? There's no way somebody trades that unless they're coming up from Secret or something, and then the push has to happen later if that's going to go, if you're going to have that angle covered. So, I mean, just far from ideal for Dignitas. They get punished this round. Bialy now just racking up kills, and Snax with that AWP, he carries it on, man, and just pick up another one.
Very well done indeed. Magisk and MSL. What are they going to do at this point in time? 2 versus 5. Virtus Pro would basically, they would have to lose their minds to lose this round. I don't know what it would take for them to give up this kind of a lead. Bit of a spray coming through from Magisk, but that will also be the end of it. So now we're looking at a terrific first half here for the Polish team. 5-3 the scoreline. I'm wondering, because that round, as soon as they get the kill on Config, they start moving outside. But if you notice, they didn't put up any smokes. So even if they hadn't got the following up kills there, yeah, they would have so many grenades to work with. I mean, normally, if you go for that yard push, you end up using almost all your grenades just to get down into Secret, right?
Mm-hmm.
Virtus Pro feeling so confident, even after one entry, they feel like, well, we're just going to not even use any up grenades.
No, we'll just run all over the place, yeah. Oh, what is this? Where did that happen? Oh, an aggressive radio push. Pasha got caught in radio by Magisk. So now Magisk actually manages to get something going. They have a kill to work with there. That is one thing that Dignitas are still fairly effective at, right? Finding an opening kill on the CT side of Nuke. Now it's about locking down the rounds, however.
They switched up the CZ, I think. Magisk still roaming around with that M4 somewhere. Config gonna maybe get a bit of a peek in here, trying to see if he gets to catch anyone out in the yard. And does spot a couple of people. It's really hard for them to do anything about it, though, with the equipment they have here. Config in a lot of trouble. It does get some damage in.
Ah, there's Bialy with the follow-up. Good teamwork, the pair. Bring it back to a 4-on-4. Still against pistols. The only rifle is on Magisk right now. Yeah, and he's down in fence, so he's going to be looking to hold the gap here in Secret. This would be a... Well, that's the main way for VP to get through. If they've got Secret control, they've got yard control, this is their way to get down onto that lower site. Now there's nobody here from Dignitas. They can rotate quickly through the vents, but they're still going to allow Virtus Pro to just get out onto this B site, it looks like.
Yeah, a bit of a gamble, I think, for Dignitas this round. I think they were hoping that VP would go for like a double fake or something like that, but Doesn't quite work out now. Smoke is going to be going up, and even a little bit of a grenade there to keep Cajun out. Just some blind shots coming through, but things are looking very good for Virtus.pro at the moment. A little bit of damage being put into Neo, actually. He's going to be going down. Rubino, the CSET 75 to get the kill. 4 versus 3D. Do not have a defuse kit, so it's going to have to be quick here for Dignitas. And with the rifle out of the round, you've got to think that might not be possible any longer. Rubino is going to reclaim it, running through the fire, trying to catch Bialy off guard, but he's playing very well at the moment. Bialy, triple kill in the round for him. Cajun, the last one left, quad kill. Bialy absolutely racking up the kills here. And that's going to be 6-3 as a scoreline.
Dude, he's at 14-04 right now, Bialy. He's just running away with this. Although I say that, Taz did have the very strong start. Taz is double digits as well at 10 kills. So, I mean, solid work. All right, then. Solid work. I mean, the thing is that Bialy, he seems to have come in to his own this term. He's getting a lot of praise on social media from the analysts as well, that his aim is on point right now. It's mechanical, it's precise, and he isn't really missing any opportunities. If you give him the chance at a duel, he's more than willing to take it, and he's winning it a lot right now as well. Although, Snacks, that's a sick start.
Oh, we are watching Dignitas getting rolled at the moment. The Virtus plow is in full effect right here. Dignitas, I would say if you're going to have a tactical timeout, then it's better be soon. It's going to be soon, because otherwise there's no stopping the polls here. It's going to be a triple kill for Bialy once again. That puts him up at 17 overall for this game already. Very, very impressive. And not the first time we've seen it throughout this tournament.
No, that's the thing. This is where Virtus.pro just get to start running away with it. And they just have so much experience in this situation. They're just clearly so confident. They're like, you know what? We're the best team here. This is our tournament now. All of the tough obstacles are out of the way. It's only Dignitas standing in our way, and these guys don't know how to win a final. So let's go and get the job done. 7 rounds, T-side on Nuke, and we aren't even done yet. We're getting into the 11th round now. So the pain train can keep on rolling here. Dignitas, this is the big round. Cajun B has got his AWP. He was effective versus Na'Vi at finding picks on the CT side out here in Yard, but Config is currently occupying the space. They're counting on Cajun to lock down. No, he's actually, all right, so they've doubled up on Yard control here, Dignitas. I do like that. Cajun is still at the back by Garage to have the angle on high exactly towards Silo. So if Bialy goes for that peek again, Cajun's going to be in position for it.
Should be a fight that Cajun wins pretty much 100% of the time. Snacks on the other side of the smoke there. Config trying to look over it. They're actually going to go into Garage. Now they're getting dangerously close to Cajun, and he only has that one back up, but that's a nice shot right through, and he picks up Bialy as well. Cajun with a good, strong double kill to start off the round with. Going to be sneaking in. Neo right on the other side, and he's going to get tagged as well. Pistols out now. He's going to look for the follow-up, and there it is, the triple. Cajun cleaning up the yard.
Yeah, and then Config, the duo comes into play. Taz has been spotted as well. And Taz is going to be able to pick up the one kill onto Config. He gets the follow-up on a Cajun. No, Cajun just barely survives, trying to get fancy with the HE. They know that Taz is low at this point. He's kind of stuck. 20 seconds left, and MSL is going to get the final kill, but that was definitely Cajun B's round. Monster play from him, just locking down the yard.
17-5 still on Bialy. That really scares me. And overall, a 7-4 scoreline. Dignitas needs to win, you know, sort of minimum the last 4 rounds here. But even then, I mean, we just saw this. We've just seen this when they were playing against Na'Vi, how much of a problem it is letting 7 rounds through on the terrorist side. Dignitas simply won that second half very convincingly.
Yeah, that's the, once you actually have the coordination on your CT side, unlike Na'Vi, Dignitas were just able to get work done. And Virtus.pro also have quite a bit of experience on this map, so it's not going to be an easy ride here for Dignitas, that's for sure. VP currently posted up, waiting.
Oh, look at where Snacks is. He is already down in the lower hallways. That's very interesting. Now they're going to make their way in through main. Magus getting shot in the feet a little bit then. That's going to be a little bit of confusing for him, but look at the entry coming in. Taz and Pasha following it up. Cajun with one kill. It's going to have to be a lot more than that right now. They're a man down, and Pasha following up. A good double for him, and Magus now alone. 1-3 with a bomb down as well. Virtus.pro getting an incredible amount of map control without having to sacrifice almost anything for it.
They were just all over the place. That's some team play. That's the coordination coming in. It seems like having Snacks down there, it works perfectly with the coordinated push through A main at that point.
I mean, the second Snacks starts shooting at Megaskin, the call is, I mean, he's going to have to call out and say, what the hell is happening? Why did he get down there? Why did no one realize or notice? That's a big gap in the defense that shouldn't be happening.
And then the rotation comes out on upper, and that's where the push is coming in through main. Pasha catches men out in the open on Heaven. Yeah, big boom. Bomb goes off, and another round on the board here for Virtus Pro. You can see just very touch and go on the money for Dignitas right now, but it's getting to the point where it's like force every round, because you need to actually start getting something going for yourself here. Granted, they did actually, I mean, they've got four rounds right now, Dignitas, and that's after losing the pistol. So, I mean, they are still actually fighting back, but it's not looking pretty, no.
Yeah.
Just a single rifle on Megas from the last round.
I would have definitely forced this round. Like, without even any question, that would have been, I wouldn't even care how much money people have, I would have just gone for it anyway. Because otherwise, you're potentially letting so much through. We'll see if Magus can make a big difference here. It's not impossible that he could catch a couple of opening frags.
Certainly not. I mean, he's been very effective from Secret. There it is. The Molotov was waiting for it. VP too thorough, especially when they have the utility advantage like this. They're too thorough to let that go by. If you have the incendiary, just throw it down there. Hell, put two. Config, you're never going to get out of here, bro. Rotate.
They use that time to clear out the rest of the yard as much as they can anyway. Neil making his way through smoke. Cajun can hear them, but can he actually do anything about it? Config finally out of the round, and Cajun will follow. Really good opening there, and they're so meticulous right now. Virtus Pro really leaving nothing to chance.
No, this is where you see the wisdom. I mean, the one thing is, Dignitas, the edge that they had going up against some of their opponents is that they've been the longer standing roster working together under MSL's leadership. They're currently playing against the longest standing roster in CSGO to date.
Yeah.
This team, Virtus Pro, they've been together for so long now with refusing to change anybody on the roster. They're just unique in the approach that, well, if there's a problem, we'll just figure out how to fix it. We have all the individual talent we need on the team and the experience of the veterans like Neo and Taz, Pasha included. We have everything necessary. So if there is a problem that comes up, it's not roster change and band-aid it. It's no, we're going to fix it for the long run. And here, once again, they're back at the top playing in a finals.
Yeah, it's hard to argue with their approach right now. It definitely seems to be working out. Some of the slumps they've had throughout even this year have been typically in a lot of online games. That's
brutal,
been a
yeah.
little bit tricky for them. But put them on land, there is a good chance they're going to be an absolutely lethal team. Meg is going to be able to save the M4 all the way back in CT spawn, which I guess is, you know, a little bit, but nowhere near enough. 9-4 as the Polish team continues to demolish the Danes here in the first map of the Grand Finals.
Gotta say, the light mapping on that stage is so sick.
It's very well done. It's been over 2 days almost, and it's, you know, you still brings a smile to your face watching it. It's, I mean, I feel like saying it's now or never, but that, I think that moment has even passed now for Dignitas here. Mm-hmm. I mean, that's why I'm shocked that they didn't just force up in the last round, because you've got to realize that now is pretty much the time to get this done here. 14th round is coming up. They have the AWP Glass Cannon on Cajun B, and they have a bit of a double push into Yard.
Yeah, they actually have the aggression. This I'm a bigger fan of, just because you can trade. If they come rushing around the corner, you can try and trade your way out of it. A big spray could make it happen. There is still, I mean, Cajun back there with the AWP as well, so there is a huge focus on Yard right now from Dignitas. Three players currently ganged up, ready and waiting. We'll see. Config hoping that he's not going to get shells rained down on him from the heavens, basically. Bialy going up onto Sila has been a go-to play for VP.
Yeah, but you see VP were expecting it. They were just not looking in the right place. They had the double grenade down behind Red there, and now Config right around the corner. He walks right in, and that's a great opening frag. Rubino going to get the refrag, but now they know he's there, and Neo takes a lot of damage in return. Going to put up a bit of a grenade to try and force him back. Sadly, Bialy's not up on the high ground right now. Might give a bit of a chance for Rubino to escape. He's only going to get back behind Red. MSL panic spray coming out, and Neo wins the fight against Rubino. That is horrible. Now Megis alone again. Seems like every time it's him against the world. Virtus Pro looking to claim a 10th round here on the T side.
Isn't that the curse of the ramp player, right?
Yeah.
If they don't come ramp, you just feel like the most useless person on the roster, because you're going into impossible retake after impossible retake.
It's almost like playing B-bomb side on Mirage, you know. Sometimes you just get no action for a long time, and then eventually you have to go and retake A because the other half of the team didn't work out. And he pulls out the knife. Oh, no. Another eventually, nightmare. Those lasers are going to go down, and if you're looking at the current pace here, it looks like VP are going to be the ones to lift that trophy. There's only really going to be Pasha who's going to be able to lift that trophy, in all honesty. Look at it.
I know, right? Well, hey, teamwork. It's at the core. It's at the heart of CS, Anders. And so it'll just obviously take some teamwork to lift it. There you go, right? One, two, three, go. And then somebody drops it, breaks a foot.
I want to imagine a world in which they pick it up at the end of the lineup and then Bialy is all the way at the end. So when it gets to him, he just sort of falls over with
yeah.
it. That would be funny. 10-4, and we are moving into the 15th round. It's only the first map, so we can't get too discouraged from what we're seeing here. I mean, there's still a chance DingTask could take a deep breath and come back on Cobblestone, which they're very good on. But right now, on this particular map, it is almost as close as it can be to being lights out here. Taz opening up on Rubino. They've obviously bought whatever they can here for the 15th round. Meg is going to be a little bit aggressive, and that pays off.
It does pay off, but Neo is waiting. That gun is now bait. Surprise, MSL. You're not getting in there. You're not going to get a rifle. You're done. And VP once again have the man advantage versus two pistols and a rifle on Ace Boy. A couple of nades for Dignitas to work with, but it really isn't looking too hot. And Config out in Garage, not going to get spotted. In fact, oh, he nearly picks up the kill on Pasha. That was so close. Pasha lives on 6 HP.
On Cajun, grenade not going to hit, actually. Pasha a little bit too far back, otherwise maybe they could have brought it back to a 3-on-3, but they still don't have very good equipment here. And Cajun, fighting for his life, is going to be going down. Neo picking up a good double kill. Magisk is again alone in a 1-on-4. Sprays 1, sprays 2. The fire catching him. He can't make it out. And Snacks will pick it up. 11-4, ladies and gentlemen, in favor of Virtus Pro. That's a bit of a statement.
Oh, man. This is actually really interesting because it feels like we're back in the groups again. Because in the groups, it was everybody winning their opponent's map apart from VP. VP were the ones to go 2-0. VP were the ones to really just, well, be for a good long while until like the end of the second day. They were the only team to actually win their opponent's map as well as their own. So, I mean, VP off to a terrific start on Nuke. And, I mean, then you're going into Cobble, which, again, VP are solid on.
They definitely are, and so are Dignitas, so that means we could still have a very good game on our hands, but you really, at this point, you're going to think that Virtus Pro are looking unstoppable. Even if Na'Vi could have made it here instead, they just look so strong. We are going into the second half any moment, but if you're a Dignitas fan, that guy's into it. I like it.
What?
All right.
Okay, then.
They were into it.
There's the real winner.
None of that kiss on the cheek, anything like that. Just going all in. 11-4 is the scoreline. We're moving into the 16th round. So once again, welcome to the show here. It's the grand finals of Epicenter. Pasha opening up, getting a kill, but they're just rushing them down. It's going to be MSL with the refrag. Instantly, the bomb is going to be going down as well. Dignitas, they're fighting right now to stay in control, or to get a little bit of control here on Nuke. And Config going to pick up two big kills there, leaving Taz and Snacks. And I think Taz knows he's boxed in.
He's stuck. Can Snacks find an angle? No, it's almost an impossibility now, especially with the flank coming in from Magisk. He's going to catch Snacks looking the wrong way. That leaves Taz alone, and the trend continues again. We're going to have teams trading pistols, but the thing here for Dignitas, although as I say that, Taz gets a great headshot there on a Magisk boy. He doesn't have time. No kit picked up. He has the Kevlar, but realizing this, he has to back off. Try and save that Kevlar for the next round. Save a little bit of money. So he will be able to make it out in one piece. Config? No. Whoa. Config and Cage and surviving on single digits.
Calculated, of course.
I mean, I think this bodes well for Dignitas because they've been really struggling. They struggled versus Na'Vi to, they would get onto the site, they would get the plant, and everything would be looking great. You know, they wouldn't drop a single person in the process, and then they'd get run over in the retake. Here, finally, they've been able to turn that around and stop Virtus Pro from actually executing the retake. They successfully bomb plant and hold the site.
I mean, it's a good way to start off a round here, but the real test is going to be in the fourth round. And actually, Virtus Pro, they're going to follow up with quite a bit of armor, and even that scout on Neo. Taz opening up with a shot on Rubino. Takes another one. Cajun out of the round. MSL finally putting an end to the madman, but 3 versus 4 at the moment. This is already frightening.
Well, Confident Magus, you're still alive. So you can't give up hope on Dignitas. You can, you know, if you cuddle Pasha, if you try and cuddle Pasha, that's where you die. He just bear hugs you. You're done.
Yeah, CSET 75 poked into his ear at that point in time. It's now a one-on-two here. Snacks left for the Deagle. It would be very impressive, but he's so far away. Even getting up there will take enough time that they pretty much can just ride out the clock here and let the bomb go off. Still, a lot of damage being output here by VP. That's going to be a little bit of a kill. Bomb will obviously go off at this point in time, and Snacks is looking to steal that AK away if he can. You see him jumping down there. Almost dies to the bomb.
Yeah, that's just an unlucky break for him. If that AK takes a tumble down, well then, I mean, you actually managed to save an AK at the end of the round. You have something to work with in the following round. But instead, I mean, I'm liking it from Dignitas. This is kind of their MO at this point. Early on, if they win that pistol, they just keep charging. Another rush for them. It's expensive, but they're still getting rounds.
See that girl blowing a kiss to the stream? Mm. Weird how if it's a guy doing it, it doesn't seem you know, quite right, does it?
Waiting for the guy, yeah, exactly. Who's going to do that?
Somehow it's just different. 11-6 is the scoreline. Magus and Config opening up. A lot more speed to this round, and Dignitas deciding they don't want to wait around, and I don't blame them. And this is where you can get really tricked, because now it seems like, all right, boots on the other foot. It feels pretty good here. 7-11 scoreline. It's possible to make this work, but this is the real test. If they lose this round, I think they're going to lose Nuke in a very, very fast manner. But if they can win it, then we could you know, open up for a small chance they could still do this.
Now we can get the three maps.
Yeah, or at least just get a closer game on this one, because it has been Virtus Pro pretty much all the way up until this point.
It has been the VP show. I'm looking right now to see where the aggression is going to come in, because again, Dignitas, it's just rush time. They are literally rushing everywhere. Magus leads the way. Neo in position to get the big spray. Manages to find one headshot at least. Brings it back to a 4-on-4. But again, Dignitas, superior utility. They have the grenades to buy all the time to get the plant, and it's not going to happen. Taz! So close, roasting, he can't deny it.
All right, that is something we haven't actually seen a lot on Nuke. That ramp rush used to be such a popular feature of old Nuke, even back in 1.6, but we haven't seen it too much on this one. Quick trade coming in, Snacks and Magus out of the round, pushing through into the fire there. Taz taking a fair bit of damage. Config and Robino, can they keep this one alive? Robino down in Toxic, just waiting inside that glass. He's getting the spray in, but he can't get the kill. And now the UMP is all that's left here. Config pushing through. He's going to get the one, but denied by Neo, who gets a quad kill. And Taz is on the defuse, and he's going to get it too. Very good round here for VP, and that was the big test.
Look what clever nade. Like, do you see the nade use there at the end with the smokes everywhere? Yes, okay, somebody puts a smoke up on the site. Sure, Taz is like, you know what? Could be better than one smoke, Anders. Two smokes. Just cover the entire site with smoke so that you can sit there and defuse without a kit for 10 seconds. That's unbelievable.
I mean, even if there's just one smoke, it can actually be really hard to guess the angle. So if there's two of them up, you know, all over the place.
It's like, where was the bomb planted?
Yeah. It's very tricky.
That's a nightmare. And it's a nightmare for Dignitas now. They do have the money to go for a buy. After such a successful start to the half, they had spare funds, but It's the hit to the confidence now. Do they actually go for another rush? That's what I'm watching for at this point.
All right, we don't have the tactical coin yet, so it's the technical issue that's being sorted out. Let's see. I mean, that was a good attempt from Dignitas, a very good attempt, in fact. That kind of an opening, and the pace that was being set there. I really enjoyed that.
I mean, but that's what VP did to Dignitas in the first half, right? And if Dignitas are going to do anything at all in the second half, they have to just try and run their heads into VP and run over them. And so that's a great call from MSL. It's an excellent leadership. But now we have to see more of the same or not. Could be a very quick play into ramp here. Magus leading the way. He's waiting for Pasha, and he does get lucky. Manages to drop Pasha down to 66 HP. But in the meantime, Dignitas, again, look at how fast and aggressive they are out into the yard. Now they've got the angle with the AWP.
This is definitely not bad. I mean, yeah, they kind of don't have a choice. You're right. They have Snacks locked in behind that box, and I'm pretty sure you can shoot right through that. Or is it only the red containers? We'll test it later. Cajun being forced back with grenades. MSL making his way around. He's going to go for the spray down, and that's a great opening frag. And taking out Snacks.
Love to see this. Dignitas showing that they've still got some fight in them. Cajun's going to catch Pasta. That was that secret, ready and waiting for it. And now Neo, locker room, will drop the bomb as well. That's a big kill. A lot of information gained for him, and he might be able to pick up the second as well. Neo continues to deliver, brings it back to a 3-on-3, eliminates all of the hard work that Dignitas did at the beginning of the round, and now they've got Cajun pinned down as well.
Yeah, right now Dignitas is spread out all over the place, and Rubino gonna end up going down. Megaskin on a huge flanking mission right now, but they needed everyone to stay alive, otherwise it's not gonna matter. And Neo, what kind of spider senses are these? He turns around, Megaskin's right behind him, there's the kill. Neo, he's gonna get the quad! What an incredible hold, bringing it back for his team.
What was that?
So impressive.
Yeah, oh stop it, he was right, Neo.
Cameraman is a god is what it says, apparently. Thanks for the translation.
I think a lot of people are appreciating the cameraman's efforts right now.
They are putting in the work. You can't take that away from them. Wow. That might have been the final nail in the coffin there, because they did a lot to open up that round. A very good effort put in by Dignitas, but a quad kill for Neo just to seal the deal. 13-7. No bomb plant, no money either for Dignitas. Although a good opening kill. Config taking out Snacks.
Headshot on Snacks and spots Neo, who's holding out by CT. Pasha gonna get overwhelmed, but he does take up two kills. That's actually very solid from him. The HE leading the way. Timing is just barely off, and Taz stands his ground to take the fight. This is turning into a very expensive round for Virtus Pro. But Megis eventually forced out into the open. That drops the bomb, and Config is now the last man alive here for Dignitas with 2 points of health left. So a little bit too close for comfort here, but VP do manage to stabilize.
And I mean, if this was the first half, we'd probably be praising Dignitas anyway and saying, well, it's great, they got three kills, you know, really good job. But the problem is they don't have enough rope to play this game with, right? They kind of need to get back in this game right now. They can't wait another 3 or 4 rounds for this to work out. That's going to lose them the game, so, or at least the map. Neo in a perfect position here, and that's going to be Config down and out. Double kill for Neo. Really doing a lot of work right now. Actually, he's up to 19 kills. Bialy at 21, Taz on 22. And there's not even anyone on Dignitas who's horribly underperforming right now. They're just being outmatched by VP.
I think that VP are the ones who are just fired up right now. You've got Neo showing that he's still got it after all this time. I mean, the round before this one, what a fantastic hold from him out in the yard. That was just him reading Dignitas every step of the way, not missing a shot. And now they're primed and ready, VP, to close out this first map. Dignitas is picked 2 rounds away. It's 14-7. And Dignitas are the ones who have to actually try and find something here to put a stop to this pain train.
But given the map choices, I feel like it almost doesn't matter. Like, it might as well have been VP that picked Nuke and Dignitas that picked Cobble. So in that sense, you know, it's not like they're going onto a map that's completely awful for them. Could have probably just swapped that around. But still, this kind of a lead, this kind of build-up for Virtus Pro, so hard to stop them when they get into this this point in the game.
Well, they are getting close. They're getting close to the main wrap, it looks like. MSL, at least, he's dancing right on the edge. Snacks has decided to change it up in case the smoke wall goes down towards Secret. He might be able to see it over it. And Taz is getting ready as well. The setup now firmly in place for VP. They've shown nothing to Dignitas. Dignitas have not had an opportunity to get an opening kill so far. And so eventually it's just going to come down to it where the clock is going to force Dignitas' hand. 40 seconds left here in the round.
Cajun alone scoped in with the AWP. If a flash came in or if he misses the shot when he walks in here, it's going to be horrendous. A bit of a smoke to buy some room for himself. The rest of his team is set up somewhere else. And actually, he's going to get the tag in on Snacks. That is a little bit of damage being output. Now they're going to go for the ramp in through main. Bialy and Taz already out on the Molotov high ground. Doesn't even matter. Snacks is going to be gone. This is a perfect execute. Very well done for Dignitas.
What fantastic work. When you're going to play like that, VP, when it comes to crunch time, you have to hit every shot. You can't allow yourself to make a mistake. And you have to be able to just lock down the crossfire. And I don't know. It looked like they managed to catch him peeking. Taz was rotating off of his spot, but they weren't ready for it in Virtus Pro when the push finally came from Dignitas. And that's the issue. If you're not being aggressive on the map, you just have no info, no early warning to go off of as to where Dignitas are going to hit. It's just they're in your face instantly. And so if you have a knife out, if you have a nade out, if you have anything, that's it. That's the round. There's no coming back from it.
And because Cajun walks in on ramp, just to get a little bit technical as well, he puts out that smoke and it forces Taz in because the other player holding ramp, which I think was Snacks, So because Pasha's having trouble because he can't see anything, he has to call Snacks in. So now Snacks is no longer on Heaven to help out when the push comes through. Very clever. It's just one person creating enough of a diversion and ramp. And Virtus Pro just a little bit miscalculating what was about to happen there. 14-8.
Wow, look at this. I mean, now VP pistols. This is the big chance. Cajun B, bit of a flash shot there onto Snacks. Going to start things off strong here for Dignitas. A bit of a nade chucked into radio as well. Maggie's can range, and Rubino's going to hold so far. Bit of a spray there onto Bialy. Wasn't the cleanest, and Neo and Pasha going to find a couple of kills, including a shotgun kill, so some bonus money going there for Pasha. But they have rifles to play with now. Neo dancing on the edge. Neo point blank. Not going to last longer than that, and not going to get another kill. But still, he made it so expensive for Dignitas in this round.
Very scary indeed. And you see the problem again. Just to reach here, I know this is like a broken record sort of thing, but only having two people in lobby is so dangerous. Did work out this time because the backup was there really quick before any rifles could really be picked up, but yeah. All right. We're going to need people to sort of create a whole highlight of all the different kiss cams.
Well, that one would have been more like establishing territory, right? Just, you know, like, don't get any ideas, guys. Don't get any ideas.
All right, then. Cajun, not quite with the flick. And Virtus Pro, not quite with the money. I don't think they even care. I don't think they're worried at all right now.
No, they've got the flow. It's all about the next round for VP. Another round where there's pistols in play here for Virtus Pro. MSL, strong start for him. Two kills. Pasha walks right into Magis. And that leaves it down to Neo now, 1v5. Not a whole lot he can hope to achieve here, apart from maybe a kill on MSL or Cage and the low players, basically. But so far, I mean, this is Dignitas. I mean, it comes back to that old cliche where it's like one round at a time, right?
Yeah, I mean, if the problem that they ended up having is... Okay, she's got all the names. I thought it was just a Neo fan. I would have appreciated that.
Yeah, no, then she had to do Pasha.
I think the problem that Dignitas have, a lot of the source of the issue here is the fact that they lost the fifth round on the first half. You know, they won once they could buy rifles, but then they got shut down the round after. And that's one of the really big issues that they're struggling with even now. Mm. That gave a lot of the first half to Virtus Pro. 14-10 the scoreline. The road back is very long, and finally VP have grenades and rifles and everything else, including Snacks out of this yard. He's so lethal out here, but almost catching him there. Cajun, ready for the fight, going to be walking right back in. He's right there, almost getting caught. Snacks is playing a dangerous game right now. Flashes are coming in, but he still finds MSL.
Sick patience from Snacks pays off. He could have tried to really force the kill on Cajun. But instead, he's like, right, if Cajun's up there, there's got to be some kind of presence in yard. Boom, gets the follow-up. What beautiful play. And now a man advantage here for Virtus Pro, who are very light on nades, so it's so crucial that they actually have some kind of edge to work with here. It's not going to be the grenades to make the difference. Rubino steps a step too far, and he's going to get punished. Magis, though, there for the trade. Still a man advantage for Virtus Pro. They maintain it.
Yeah, there's a bit of an opening here, though. It's not entirely impossible. We're down to 50 seconds, and that is a problem, but... as soon as they can pick up that bomb, they can start to make their way towards the site. It's on the right side of the wall for Dignitas, so it's not sure if Virtus Pro know it. And oh, free kill there. Neo getting a bit too aggressive and ends up going down now. It's a 2-on-2. There's still a Molotov and an HE Gref left here on the Dignitas side. And no smokes for the defuse on VP.
Yeah, an uncharacteristic mistake from Neo. But let's see if his teammates can bring it back. The only issue here is that they have no kits. So with no nades, no kits, it's down to the shots, and they need Dignitas to make a mistake. Dignitas still have that single HE, but Config gonna walk into Taz, win that duel handily, and that pretty much ends it. At this point, Snacks, you just gotta back off and accept your fate that this round is going Dignitas' way. A 1v2 clutch with no kit, I mean, that's a bit of a tall order even for you.
Yeah, oh well, just no scoping Cajun, why not? Gonna go back for it, taps the bomb again. Config, does he realize? He might not know he doesn't have a kit. Snacks gonna get shot in the back, and it will be the round for Dignitas. I do want to point out, we did also see Guardian do a 1-on-4 with the AWP in that bomb site, so I'm not gonna rule anything out, but...
sure, but Guardian was there right as the bomb got planted. Like, he was just... it was a different scenario, right? I mean, there it's just like you've wasted 20 seconds. You have no kit, and it's 1v2.
It should never be a win for Snacks. But I mean, if Config had peaked right away, then that would have been really scary.
Is that the beauty, right? Like, ah, well.
14-11.
He did give us a little bit of a show, I guess. The no scope is pretty neat.
Yes, that was not at all bad. Virtus Pro investing in some smoke grenades this round, hopefully, or I think hoping to try and see if they can sort of create a little bit of a forced error on Dignus House. Maybe they push somewhere they don't need to and feel a little bit panicked.
I think VP are starting to feel the heat a little bit here for sure. Snacks taking Config spot over in secret. Might catch Cajun looking the wrong way, but then Cajun has got Config there to watch secret. So this is why he's taking that wide angle. He's stepping way out onto Silo, is because he's trusting in Config to be there. Oh, the chance there for Snacks. Just a little bit too slow on the trigger. Config so fast. Saves himself. That could have been a two kill advantage for Virtus Pro. That would have been massive.
Neo is lethal with this scout. They are behind the smoke, but it doesn't cover everything. He's going to get one more headshot in. If that flick had worked, I would have just lost it. But it's going to be 3 versus 4 here instead. Virtus Pro with a man lead, but still with terrible equipment. They are going to be going back, and you can tell Virtus Pro heard that. They already had Bialy, I think it was, down in the hallways, and he heard them running back.
It's unbelievable, but now, like, they can't actually pick up the guns over there, so that's the frustrating thing here for Virtus Pro. They're stuck on these pistols. It's only Neo with the scout.
The time. 25. They've got no map control. They have to check every corner, and they only have 20 seconds left. This could be horrendous. This could be map point right now. You see them walking in, and Pasha gonna pick up the kill on MSL. Rubino and Meg is left. Oh no, 15 seconds out in the open. Meg is in a 1-on-3. He's gonna go down. Neo with a triple kill. Two of them to start off the round with, and they just did not have the time to play that game. 15 rounds here for VP.
And that's it. Now it really sets in on Dignitas. An eco round win as well. Apart from the scout, everybody else on pistols, that's the worst. Dignitas are going to tilt so hard now. Like, this will be the true test of Dignitas, if they can come back and force overtime.
We cut too soon.
Come on!
Now it can't be in the compilation, obviously. It will be 15-11, the 27th round here, Dignitas. I say 4 rounds in a row, but they're not all going to be rifle rounds for VP. If they can just win this round, maybe it's possible, but Pasha shutting down Cajun, who's had pretty good success in ramp so far, and even sort of exploding the AWP towards him.
Shots? Nope. Snack's not going to get it. But man advantage for VP is huge. And now, well, you have Neo with the AWP, not feeling too bad about that, considering how well he's doing with the scout. Just let him keep sniping, that's fine.
See how Config is shooting and then looking back towards Secret, really trying to lure someone out. Good idea, but didn't work this time. Taz in a position that's quite hard to check when you're coming out of hut.
Oh, did look like there's a pre-fire there. Snack's going to find the kill on MSL. And just like that, two-man advantage now for VP going into the key round here. Dignitas with their backs to the walls, and Bialy's going to get the drop on Magus. They can't catch a break, Dignitas. Taz is going to get Rubino. And now it's all Config going for the sneaky plays out in yard, but in the meantime, your entire team is dead, and so are you. Snacks ends it, and that is it. VP will be picking up Nuke.
I mean, that seemed almost destined to happen given the first half scoreline, but very impressive fight for Dignitas. They definitely were not giving up, so a lot of credit to them for sticking in this game, but they had made their lives very tough already, and Virtus Pro, they're a beastly team right now.
Monsters. And yeah, I mean, look at that. Taz, always the showman, loves the showboat, play to the crowd. And yeah, I mean, again, this almost feels like it's home turf for them. I mean, obviously their organization is based out of Moscow, so the team owners, everybody is here from Virtus Pro, but it does feel like they have the crowd behind them as well, which is a huge edge now, considering VP, I mean, considering they're in the lead and they're just looking so good.
Yeah, very, very impressive. I mean, the one big hope here for Dignitas House is they can have a little bit of a break and now go into Cobblestone, which they are very strong and they've been very good on. Yeah. So Virtus Pro, but I mean, I think we could still be seeing an interesting game on that map.
No doubt about it. I think it could still be just as even. Now Dignitas It's like, okay, it didn't go our way with Nuke. We gave away way too many rounds in the first half. It's going to be way too hard to come back into it. We made them work for it, though. So VP, they had to give up some, you know, I guess give up some energy, whatever, right? Like, they had to work for it in the first map. Now Dignitas can come into the second map and start with a strong start on Cobblestone, where they're definitely feeling comfortable. We've seen great maps from them so far this tournament on that map. Totally possible to take it to map three here still. Can't count Dignitas out yet.
I agree with that. We'll see if the analyst desk does as well. I look forward to it. Are we going to see a map three, gentlemen? Tell us.